All right, we're doing some more Mafia. I think I may have fixed some stuff. Instead of display capture, I have game capture on now. I tested it out a little bit last night. Didn't progress in the story, but I just walked around and seemed to be doing much better. So let me just. See how that goes. Are having a good day today. I have. My day's been pretty chill.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car. Last I saw Frank, there was no sign of this. He had a drink.
Seems a little better. I don't know though.
Tough day today, Tom.
We gotta keep a lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got you a clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it.
Oh, hell yeah.
Frank sees a LaPara, he'll know. The old ways work.
Yes, last time we left off, Frank turns out he's a traitor. Death gives a permanent wave.
You must see me!
And now for the latest news. The Navy is today continuing its search for the remains of those brave souls lost aboard the airship USS Akron. The Akron was destroyed in a violent thunderstorm off the New Jersey coast Tuesday morning with the loss of 73 of 76 aboard. The disaster stands as the worst aviation accident on record. Yesterday, one of the survivors, Lieutenant Commander Herbert B. Wiley, spoke to members of the press and gave a brief account of the tragedy. He also spoke of the survivors' rescue by the German tanker, Phoebus. President Roosevelt has described the loss of the Akron as a national disaster and said that he grieves with the wives and families of those...
at Biff's place.
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
Depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
How'd you hear?
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Little Tony.
Always a pleasure, Tommy.
Damn.
Welcome to a WLH sports report. There's a sense of anticipation as we await the start of the big game. Our very own Lost Heaven Lancers are out on the road, deep in enemy territory as they take on bitter rivals, the Empire Bay Cannons. This year's Gold Series is shaping up to be one of the best on record, with both teams matching one another blow for blow. Despite the Cannons' home field advantage and an early lead in the series, the Lancers have bounced back and have really taken their rivals to task. Many of the plaudits and column inches have been dedicated to one man. Lancers pitcher Bunny Smith is one of this year's standout performers. And with this series tied at 3-3, he may well be the key man that brings the Whitman Trophy back to Last Heaven. But doing so will be no easy task, as standing in his way is opposition captain Foghorn Jack Seidel. His solo home run in the bottom of the fifth inning of Game 5 turned events in favor of the Empire Bay team. Victory was canceled out by the Lancers in Game 6, and we now have a powder keg finale that is sure to have everyone glued to their radios. Can Bunny Smith bring it home for Lost Heaven, or will the Cannons' towering redhead have the final say? WLH 570 Lost Heaven Radio will carry live coverage of the final game.
This time period is just so interesting.
Everything okay, Tom?
The Lost Haven Lancers play the Empire Bay Cannons at the Armory, with one team certain to make home for the trophy. After a heroic campaign filled with exhilarating twists, Captain Bunny Smith will lead his men onto the diamond and to play for the Lancers' first series victory in over two decades. There is a collectible here. Terror Tales. Two strongly contrasted novelettes of unusual terror. Mistress of the Dark Pool, Test Tube Frankenstein. Interesting. Well, Tony.
Nah, it's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Counselor Gilati's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI. They were all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see Frank straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No, he didn't.
Tom, what's going on?
Nothing good.
We return now to the coverage of Game 7 of the Gold Series. And by the looks of it, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be underway any minute now. The crowd here in the Armory are restless. You can almost taste the tension as we approach this, the deciding game between these two famous rivals. More than a little bad blood between them, and more than a couple of nasty flare-ups in recent years. Of course, this occasion, more than any other, could prove feisty, what with the drama that closed out the previous game. That, of course, saw the Lancers win to tie the series, and it's not often Empire Bay and Lost Heaven can boast the game's best current hitter and pitcher, respectively. I refer, of course, to Foghorn Seidel, a man mountain with a shock of red hair, and Lancers star Bunny Smith. Speaking of Smith, he is jogging, I suppose you'd say, between his teammates, issuing last-minute orders. They seem responsive to whatever he's saying. He commands respect from his team, that is for sure. By goodness, there must be some nerves among some of the younger Lancers, Elms, Graveson, and Nicholson. Smith seemed to have pepped them up. That's good to see. That's what a good captain does. The Cannons lineup is meandering over to the home team dugout. The Lancers are slowly taking up their position, so we can't be too far away from the opening pitch. Here at the Armory, the home of the Empire Bay Cannons. Stay with us for more.
Oh, come on.
proven to cause no irritation or tobacco hangover.
Looks like the place. Take me to those account books, Frank.
And we return now to coverage what could be the final play of this game and the series between the Lost Heaven Lancers and the Empire Bay Cannons. A quick reminder that this final inning is being brought to you by Swift Cola. When you need a lift, reach for a Swift. It's not only a taste sensation, it's guaranteed to increase focus, drive, and mental clarity. Pick up a bottle of Swift Cola today. And as we are coming to a close, let me thank today's other sponsors, Big Break Cigarettes and Lost Heaven Courier. Both of these teams could be said to be entering golden eras. Each team has a star player at the core with promising youngsters set around them. I refer, of course, to Smith and Seidel. The Cannons have had several such golden periods. The Lancers, it's fair to say, have not. I can see Lancers manager Frankie Hodge prowling in front of the dugout, gesticulating. He seems animated, to say the least. Looks like he's putting one of the officials in his place, or something or other. With the noise of the crowd, it is quite hard to say for sure. Whatever's going on down there, you can feel the sense of occasion, and you just know that whatever happens, the crowd will be the first to tell you what has happened. The Lancers are now within minutes of snatching the Gold Series, which at one stage had appeared doomed, but they equally teeter on the edge of defeat. It all comes down to the final play. Nobody is warming up in the bullpen. Nobody down there is considering the possibility of extra innings. Bunny Smith then, standing on the mound, a look of steely determination on his face. He's betraying no emotion, doesn't look nervous or tired after his exertions this series, nor does he appear to be carrying the weight of expectation. He's having a word with the umpire about something or other. What a strapping fellow. 6'2", 195 pounds. If the Lancers are to win here today, he's going to write himself into the record books. And boy, oh boy, what that would mean to the people of Lost Heaven after such a long time without glory on the diamond. All right, they've sorted out whatever was going on. Here we go then. In for the Cannons, it's Paddy Dougherty. Smith is pitching the game of his life, but Dougherty's a big man. If he can catch one, it could run, and with bases loaded, the Cannons would have it. Here we go. Dougherty facing down Smith. Pass ball.
Shit. They're taking you to the airport, Frank.
Some speed on that ball, my goodness. It's fair to say Dougherty looks a little spooked. He was convinced he had it. His body language tells the tale. Smith remains cool under pressure, not a flicker of emotion on his face. He winds up. And that's two. There was zip on that one. Good Lord. Seidel is barking something at Dougherty, but we have no chance of hearing it as the noise of the crowd reaches fever pitch. Dougherty's gesturing, and that's only making Seidel more irate. This is it, folks. Another strike, and the Lancers win. If Dougherty can get behind it, surely the Cannons will get all their men home and snatch victory. A swing and a miss, and that's the winners! Lancers win!
Oh, yeah!
And Smith,
nice.
Cracks an elated smile. He's thrown his cap in the air, as have his teammates. Lancers win the 1933 Gold Series!
Yeah. Okay.
Christ, they're flying him out of state or something. Fuck, this ain't good.
No, no, it's not. Shit.
So it's like that. We got a problem here.
Aha. I don't have a fucking pistol. Okay. I can hold two shotguns. Interesting.
Morello hasn't the honor to even show his face.
For a rat like you? Nah. Get in the car.
So what happens next? Once Morello gives us the books, our accountant guys will go through them with a fine-tooth comb.
Yeah, but won't Salieri's guys fly the rule before we're done?
No, that's why we round them up. Pin charges on them we know won't stick, but that keeps them in their cells long enough for the scales to tip.
This is gonna be some day for
looking. We're not giving up. Oh, got him. Get him.
I'm right here.
I
Gotcha. Oh shit.
Get him before he gets me.
Ah, Frank Coletti. To hear the soft Sicilian burr of Coletti's voice should make the blood of a right-minded individual run cold. This is the voice of a man, an advisor, who has doomed so many policemen, politicians, criminals, all who displease. Don and Salieri meet their end at Coletti's softly spoken request. Outwardly, he is refined and dignified, but this mask, the callous heart of a man who has ravaged the fair nature of lost heaven. Fucking hell. Really?
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our lives and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over yet?
I'm not so stupid, Don. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this. It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank downtown. I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of them. Told them to get on a plane.
Go on, March, Alice. Get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank...
Get on the plane, March. For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the Don to put two in my temple.
God damn you, Frank.
Oh my God, what the plane fucking explodes.
Sir.
Where's the safety deposit boxes?
With my colleague downstairs, sir.
Thanks.
Beautiful day, huh?
Uh-huh.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
I try. Gangsters Monthly, a trip to the count country, muddy bloody mayhem in the boondocks with our beloved bootleggers. Yes, oh, these are cool. I like how it shows her with the fucking Tommy gun. That's awesome.
I need to access the deposit boxes for Frank Coletti.
Yes, Mr. Angelo?
Yeah.
Mr. Coletti said it might be you who came, and to provide access. Please, follow me.
Interesting how he already knew. That's kind of weird.
I got the books and covered my tracks. Salieri never asked any questions. In fact, apart from the funeral, I never heard him talk about Frank again.
You're making my boys twitchy, Marku.
Sergio and I just came by to pay respects, that's all. Known Frank a long time. Almost as long as you. He's a good man. Smart. Loyal. Loyal to his wife. His kid above all else. There must be some kind of honor in that, in you.
Maybe. But I'm still looking at this headstone with his little girl's name on it.
It's a hell of a thing.
Who kind of looks like Babe Ruth? I don't know if that's just me, but he kind of has a look to him. Visiting rich people.
Look at these houses. Big yards, white picket fences. It's the American dream, eh, Tommy?
I suppose.
Not for you?
No, sir. I like being closer to the business.
Don't let the flower beds and front porches fool you. There's more criminals out here than in the rest of the city combined.
Are that why we're in the neighborhood?
In a way. Murrell's got a dirty prosecutor on his payroll named Watkins. Turns out he's old friends with Galati.
The city councilor?
The same. Morell let drop that we might have had something to do with the Galati boy's death. Now Watkins is loaded for bear, trying to do right by his buddy. Word is, he's striking gold with a few witnesses.
You have names?
Yeah. But Paulie and Sam are taking care of them. I'm putting you on a different part of the job. We need whatever Watkins has got on us.
Well, where's he holding?
A safe in his villa.
I'm no safe cracker.
Don't worry about that. We're taking you to meet Salvatore. He's fresh off the boat, but he knows how to pop open anything. Just get him into the villa, find the safe, and he'll do the rest.
What kind of rumpus should I expect?
Nothing you can't handle. Watkins is going to the theater, so the house should be empty except for a bit of muscle. The office is on the first floor, and Arstuli says the safe is in the wall. Once Salvatore has the safe open, grab all the evidence and get out.
That him, boss?
Yeah, that's our guy. Salvatore, tutto bene?
Sì, grazie, Don Salieri.
Good to see you. You know the job. Don't let me down.
Sì, ho capisco.
Tommy, if you bump into Watkins, don't kill him. It'll just bring down more heat.
You got it, boss.
Buona fortuna, ragazzi.
Tommy Angelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
Meraviglioso. Per favore.
think if I turn, I have my brightness up a little higher, and I feel like it's weird. It's just, That makes that this much more sense.
Parli almeno un po' di italiano. Il capo ti ha detto il piano.
I don't speak Italian.
Eccellente.
Yeah.
Fantastico. No plan?
Yeah, the boss told me.
Please. Understand. Entriamo dal labirinto senza farci sentire né vedere. La cassaforte è dietro un dipinto al primo piano. Dammi un po' di tempo e lascia fare tutto a me. Quella cassaforte avrà sicuramente un allarme.
Yeah. This is gonna be a long night for the both of us.
Ah, Cristo Santo.
Yikes. I thought he did. He seemed to know a little bit.
Okay, my turn. Do what I do. Do not get caught.
Sì.
You gotta keep safe.
Safe? Sì. It's my job. Apro cassaforte. Open safe.
Christ. Okay. Radio. Let's listen to the radio.
Eccellente. A volte questo paese è stupendo. Entriamo da lì.
Over. Wall. Labirinto.
What?
Vedrai.
Oh, a maze.
Sì, un labirinto.
Stay here while I take out the guards.
A quanto pare in America hanno il labirinto.
See what this one is. Super Science. The Big Book of Science Fiction. Prisoner of Time, a novel of tomorrow's destiny, The Missing Day.
That's all of them. Salvatore! Where are you? We're clear.
Tommy! I hear!
Tommy, or... Salvatore...
Where the hell did he go?
Sono qui, Tommy!
Guy's a pain in the ass.
Forza! Vieni, con me!
What?
Oof.
Sei un tipo tosto, eh?
What?
I thought this was a pool. It is. It's supposed to be a pool. I'm pretty sure.
Where are you?
Look for a dipinto.
What?
Da Vinci, Caravaggio, hai capito?
Painting? You're saying it's behind the painting?
Si, si.
Okay, I understand.
He said Da Vinci.
Non quello.
Guess we got another room to check.
A Da Vinci painting. Pent pamphlet. America will not fall into temptation. Prohibition must not be repealed. Do not get drunk on wine would lead to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the spirit.
Another here, Salvatore.
Dime Comics. You're the crime in my coffee. Lie down, you're dead. Gun here. Empire Bay, mob boss murdered. Spectacular pictures of vile kingpin's fiery end. Notorious racketeer Tommaso Moretti was killed outside his Empire Bay residence last Thursday afternoon. The sole victim of a car bomb undoubtedly planted by an underworld rival. Bay residents will hope that Moretti's death brings to an end of a spate of gang violence that has rocked their city in recent months. Few will mourn his passing.
Sembra di
only wall behind here.
Adore, piace la roba costosa.
Push it here.
Another here, Salvatore. Nothing again. There's one.
Niente.
Who are you? Ma'am! Ma'am! Someone help us!
We're not here to hurt you. Just get out of the house.
Whoopsie. Ennio Salieri. In 1908, Ennio Salieri first stood on American soil without a dime to his name. Within 10 years, he was a capo to the infamous Don Pepone. Within 20, the head of his own family, the good folk of Little Italy, lost heaven. Little Italy lost heaven. See him as a champion of the common man. The police department begs to differ. His charge sheet will be a litany of smuggling, extortion, swindling, and murder. If, of course, anyone ever manages to haul him in. Okay.
Electric upstairs.
Okay.
There's one.
Maybe.
Guess we got another room to check.
God damn. Prosecutor Watkins, I am writing to thank you. If you can truly give us reliable witnesses, testimonies, and evidence that Salieri has had Billy killed, I'll be in your debt. The priest's story never rang true, and now he's dead and buried. This feels like our last throw of the dice. If witnesses ask for too high a price, I will cover it. Likewise, our mutual friend will be able to apply some pressure. Stamping out Salieri and his family will be good for us all. These are dangerous times. I worry for your safety and the safety of your family. You will soon receive some men at your home who will protect you. With gratitude, Roberto.
There it is.
Bravo. Scusa.
Sure. Show me what you can do.
Quick, Salvatore! Pacienza, pacienza!
Nice work, scusa me.
Ah, cura! Ed ha collegato l'allarme!
What?
Inzappolato!
Doesn't matter. Come on, we need to get out of here.
Vai dietro, dietro.
They gotta be upstairs. The safe's in his
Oh. All right, I gotta be right back. Give me a second. Thank you.
back.
Alright, let's finish this up.
Adi!
Salvatore, stay back! I'll deal with him.
Shoot him!
Run into cover!
You're gonna burn!
Get your first time.
It's taking them so long.
He's not in the vehicle. Move in now.
He's asking me to wait for him, but he's not moving. Oh my god. What a rough start. Come on, Salvatore. Get a fucking move on. Let's go. Move. Alright. Unless it wants me to go all the way out.
Upstairs. The safe's in his study. Hey.
There you go. Oh boy.
You don't get to go home
Salvatore, stay back! I'll deal with him.
Get
your first time.
The lock, dipshit.
Forza! Andiamocene! Presto! Semina gli spiriti!
I know! Whatever you're saying, I know!
Police?
Woo!
con te, è sempre così?
He's gone. Go back to patrols.
Ah, grazie a Dio.
Salvatore, where do I take you now?
Home.
Yeah, where home?
Six and Maple.
Okay, let's go.
Nice. Okay, forgot. Yep, I know. These old cars can't do that really well. Damn!
Cristo Santissimo!
This is how I was driving when I first started the game. Not good, oh my god.
Devo dirti una cosa, al nostro prossimo lavoro penso io alla casaforte, hai capito? Ci ho quasi rimesso la pelle in quella villa ed è tutta colpa tua. E impara almeno un po' d'italiano per rispetto della nostra patria. Ah, è come parlare al mio cane, lo so, ma Cristo, dovevo dirlo, non farlo mai più, mai più.
Ok, ok. Sure.
Get your officers now! Any cars around North Park?
Wow, fuck.
Reporters?
Oh, shit. Hey, fuck nuts. Can you move? Excuse me.
Good night.
Night.
Yikes, that was... Great deal. 1935.
This is the last of the good stuff, boss.
I know. Some of those bottles I've had for 10 years. But we gotta make payroll. Get it out of here.
You've heard them. Load it up.
Good to see you, boys.
Boss.
Look at Paul. He's swagging.
You did fine, Tom. Galati's got nothing on us now. We bought some time. At least until the money runs out.
Don't go selling off the farm yet, boss.
Sam says you worked out an angle.
Yeah. And you're gonna love it. We make a few bucks and knock out a couple of Morello's teeth, too.
Okay, what's the rumpus?
A couple of weeks ago, I'm relaxing in the cigar lounge at the Blue Tropics.
Where?
Some small-time whorehouse. It's just a couple of closets with some mattresses on the floor.
It's a gentleman's club. They got a bar and everything. Anyways, one of the Johns is south, And he's crying to the madam about all his troubles. He catches my ear on account of his goofy accent. He's going on and on about how he just landed this huge payday.
But the goons he's working for are already twisting his arm. And he's got the busted nose to show for it.
You pick up his tab?
Hell no. But I walked him out of the place, took him to the diner around the corner to sober up. We get to talking. Turns out his name is Gates. He's this hick up from Kentucky.
Moonshiner?
Better. His pop's got a couple of real distilleries, and I'll give you one guess as to their exclusive buyer around these parts.
Morello.
And you think he wants to burn bridges?
Oh, yeah. I've been working him steady, boss. He's bringing up another shipment tonight, but he's got his entire crew ready to roll over. All we gotta do is make it look like a proper heist.
I don't know, Polly. You really trust this guy?
He's got no love for Morello, I'll tell you that.
Not like we got a lot of options here. We'll be cutting up the last beam pretty soon, boss.
What do you think, Tom?
We need to replace the Canadian. If Polly says this Gates can do that, I'm in.
Where's the meat?
The big parking garage downtown.
Okay, do it. But you better not be playing grab ass this time. You take Carlo and Little Bill with you.
Little Bill.
Sure thing, boss.
Once you have the truck, drive it back here.
We won't let you down, boss.
Don't make me regret giving you some time out there in the streets with the guys, Carlo.
You don't have to worry about me.
I know I don't. Tommy does that for me.
I'll keep your driver safe, boss.
Buona fortuna, boys.
Sam and Little Bill said to meet him downtown.
Got the whole squad in the car.
You okay, Carlo? Looking kind of like you shake yourself.
Ah, get bent.
Big moment, huh? Finally running with the pack.
Listen, I spend more time with Adon than all of you've put together.
Sure. Sat out on the road waiting till he's finished with his broad.
Must you always come and remind
If you don't want me to come, I won't. It's fine. Boss doesn't have to know.
Nah, you're coming. The boss said you're coming. Just, you got a face like you're being taken for an errand. I don't want Gates thinking we're frails.
Why is Gates selling Morello Williams?
First time Gates pulled in with his trucks, Morello decided to change up the terms. The big guy himself popped him in the nose as part of their renegotiation.
His nose is gonna get more than a pop if Morello hears we're involved.
That's why we're pretending to stick him up. Then he'll go back to his pop and tell a sob story about being robbed at gunpoint. He'll convince his old man that Morello can't protect the merchandise. He'll need to find a new buyer out here, and he's heard of a stand-up guy named Salieri.
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Polly told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gotten worse.
Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Till then, shut your damn...
Watch the road! Watch it!
That's trying.
What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. Till then, shut your damn mouth.
Whatever helps you sleep. When Morello tracks you down, don't come crying to me.
You serious? You actually serious?
Fellas, knock it off. Christ.
Yeah. I'm hauling it. Watch out, lady!
We got police coming!
Ah, fuck. Why the lady, bro? They're so dumb. God damn, I blame it on her. It's all her fault. That's a bull honky.
WBDS broadcasting live from Behringer.
Okay, Carlo? Looking kind of like you shake yourself.
Get bent.
Big moment, huh? Finally running with the pack.
Listen, I spend more time with Adon than all of you've put together.
Sure. Sat out on the road waiting until he's finished with his broad.
If you don't want me to come, I won't. It's fine. Boss doesn't have to know.
Nah, you're coming. The boss said you're coming. Just, you got a face like you're being taken for an errand. I don't want Gates thinking we're frails.
Why is Gates sell or Morello winning this?
First time Gates pulled in with his trucks, Morello decided to change up the terms. The big guy himself popped him in the nose as part of their renegotiation.
His nose is gonna get more in a pop if Morello hears we're involved.
That's why we're pretending to stick him up. Then he'll go back to his pop and tell a sob story about being robbed at gunpoint. He'll convince his old man that Morello can't protect the merchandise. He'll need to find a new buyer out here, and he's heard of a stand-up guy named Salieri.
This plan is some bullshit, Tom. Pauly told it to me yesterday, and somehow it's gotten worse.
Hey, when you get a lead for the boss, and you don't just drive him places, then you get to pick holes. So then, shut your damn mouth.
Whatever helps you sleep. When Morello tracks you down, don't come crying to me.
You serious? You actually serious?
Fellas, knock it off. Christ.
Oh, yeah.
Woof.
Ah, bro. My turn, bitch.
I do a lot of deals here. Parking attendant don't ask for much dough. Always closes up shop till I'm done.
Okay, we're good. Gates is waiting up on the top floor.
Alrighty.
Place seems clear so far.
Only people with cars are people with jobs. 9 to 5, place is deserted.
Well, we got jobs and we're here.
That kind of a job, sure.
Any second, boys? Nope, okay. That's right.
Anything else we need to know about Gates, Polly?
Only that he's got a bust-up nose and crates full of the good stuff.
Our kind of guy.
Our kind of guy.
Good stuff that y'all talking about.
Park up over there.
Pauly! Good to see you, pal.
Yeah. Oh,
wow.
You too, Gates.
Well, I hope you all have good taste in whiskey.
I ain't really the expert here.
Tommy.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. It's fine. Your first payment. If the Don's impressed, he'll finance more rents.
And each one's gonna be bigger than the last. We're all gonna be rich, boys.
Well, we're always happy to do business with good folks like Don Salieri. Please, give him my regards.
Sure thing. Now we just gotta conclude this transaction.
Damn.
Damn it, Pauly!
No! It's okay.
Oh. What? I told you we gotta make it look like a proper robbery.
Damn thing's gonna be crooked by the time I'm done with this city.
Ah, don't worry, pal. With all the dough you're raking in, you're gonna be able to pay for a new one.
Oh, shit.
Watch out!
No.
Took a bullet.
Come on, Gates.
This ain't as bad as it looks. Now take the booze and get. My guys will come for me. Go. So long as you guys clear them out up ahead, I'll be safe here with the little guy.
Carlo, in the cab with me. You know you stead. Tommy, check for more of them. This thing ain't over. Come on, I'll back you up.
Mm. they want me to get my car?
We got more of them. Oh my god!
The truck can't get through this! We gotta put it out! Look for extinguishers or something! I see fire sprinklers up on the ceiling! We need to turn them on! There's gotta be a valve to turn someplace! Is there a way through this fence?
Gotcha now!
Motherfucker!
Bad.
All right, guys, let me take a look at my terror tales real quick. God forbid, the damned may dance with Satan. What the fuck? What's this over here? Oh, grenades. That car, blacksmith.
I see him! Get into cover!
It's hard to find cover in an open car lot, bro. No, motherfucker. What the fuck? Who?
Grab a set of wheels and watch my back.
Sure, Sam.
Alrighty.
How the hell did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
Maybe something's up with Sam or Paul.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit him where it hurts!
Oh!
more guys after us!
Oh my god! What am I supposed to do in this situation? What? That was so unfortunate.
How the hell did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts!
Okay, can I get going? How's the car's health already at low? What am I supposed to do? Oh my god. Shit's fucking thing slow as hell.
How the hell did Morello hear about my deal?
All kinds of beefers in this city. For now, let's get the booze back to the warehouse and try not to die.
I knew it! We got more guys on us!
Okay, let's slow them down some.
Hit them where it hurts!
Wow! God! This thing is so slow. There's literally nothing I can do. Wow!
So I guess we are too.
Jesus Christ.
Lost them all.
Thank Christ for that. Let's head home. See what we got.
We got the booze. I mean, I know it didn't go to plan, but we got the booze.
Yeah. So tonight, me and you are gonna drink a bunch of it.
I guess we earned that much.
Jesus.
Like a 38. Morello's boys caught up with you?
Yeah, boss. We took care of it.
What about the kid from Kentucky?
Well, he took a slug to the shoulder, but he's a tough blocker. He and his crew dusted out as soon as we bumped off Morello's hatchet men.
Getting shot will give Gates and his pop another reason to ice Morello out of the whiskey business.
Well, let's see if this hooch was worth all the trouble. Excellent. I'll work out the details with Papa Gates. But once we're running this Kentucky Brown, we'll be back in brass buttons. Good work, son. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of all of you. Salud!
Salud!
Yeah. Alrighty. Okay, remote.
Sounds like Salieri was getting ready to make his move.
Working up to it, maybe. But then, Prohibition ended. And the bootlegging business got knocked on its ass.
Oh.
You know, that fighting over booze meant next to nothing. It took us a few years to recover.
A few years?
When it did bounce back, boy, it was something. We took what dough we had from the moonshine and Canadian whiskey and invested it into new records. Some of them even legal. Construction, restaurants, trucking, gambling. We branched out into everything, except peddling dope. By 35, things were looking up. We had good money rolling in on the regular. I had a wife and daughter. Sam was running a club for the Don. Even Paulie had a few records of his own. Wasn't exactly happy, but what do you call it? Content.
Yes.
Yeah, that was it. And Salieri, he finally starts talking about getting out of Morello's shadow. Maybe buying our own cops, our own politicians.
That's interesting. You think Salieri was sourcing highbinders in 34?
Maybe. Why?
Well, a few years back, a voice squad got a judge on solicitation of a minor. Once in the box, he started confessing all sorts of misbehaving, trying to get a deal. But he copped to taking kickbacks from Morello and your man Salieri. Playing him off one another, trying to goose the take. But once Morello found out, he threatened to bury the judge's kids on the beach, still breathing, of course.
Christ. That was the missing piece.
How's that?
Morello was always winding us up. But he never did anything that might start an all-out war. Learning Salieri was building his own bench must have finally tipped his scales. Because in 35, he hit us with both barrels.
Aye. 35. 2 years later.
With his face and pasted it
hey,
on his face.
Tommy.
Oh, hey, boss. What's going on?
I'm glad you're here.
There you go, boss. I'm going to Pepe's for lunch, but Carlo called in sick. You up for a drive?
Sure, boss.
Bravo. I'm already starving. You got a piece on you?
Yeah. You think I'll need it?
You know how it is. Things with Morello have been a little quiet lately. Maybe it's just got me jumpy, is all.
Okay. Damn, look at this bad boy. My lord. What a lanky motherfucker. Ooh.
So how's business, Tom?
You know how it is. It's good.
Sure, I know the business. I see the books every day. But since what happened happened, I know that a capo needs to talk to his soldiers without some other guy getting in the way.
Damn. I guess we're mixing with a better sort of person, though. And I like dealing with all these big shots we got on the pad. Anything's better than those grifters trying to shift their hooch before the 21st went through.
Ah, this is only the start of it, Tom. I got plans. Plenty of good people lining up for a slice.
Glad to hear it.
Be nice for you. Some time away from Polly and his cockamamie schemes.
That's better conversation, boss. I'll give you that.
Sure I am.
Me, Sam, and Polly, though, we're still real tight. We've been through some times together.
Yeah, don't I know it.
More wine here, please, quickly.
Pepe.
You're going to love this wine. It's a... Don Salieri. Welcome, my friend. Welcome.
Good to see you, Pepe.
Yes. Hey, come. Our guest has arrived, eh?
What's on the menu today?
My mother. She would be so honored if you tried her caponata.
Excellent. Bravo, bravo.
Oh, Benny. Oh, let me get you a chair for you, huh? See, please. And to drink a Chianti. I've been saving this just for you.
Yeah, bene, bene, bene. Okay.
Enjoy, huh?
I'm glad you're off the roof, Tom.
Sarah threatened to leave me if I didn't dry out.
I know.
She told you.
No. I put her up to it.
What?
Drunkards get sloppy, Tom. I didn't want you to make a mistake we couldn't live with.
Okay.
For you? And for you.
Pepe, the meal is a masterpiece as always.
Molto grazie, Don Salieri. Praise from such a gourmet as you, it filled me with joy.
You wouldn't call me a gourmet if you knew what I had for supper.
Whoa.
Get down!
Let me finish my wine.
Son of a bitch.
Hey, Salieri! Come out of there and we'll make this quick.
Smoke him out, Joe.
Shit, watch out!
That's not smoke, that's a fucking grenade.
We aren't going out the front door. Can you move?
Not fast enough. We're gonna ambush these boys. I'll keep them entertained while you circle around.
You sure, boss?
Blow them all down, Tommy. Not one of them goes home tonight.
Okay, boss. Be careful.
Yeah.
Tom, just be quick about it.
Go, run, go, run.
Run these creases, Tommy. Take them all out.
Let's go. Reload. Ammo. Beautiful.
Got you now! Bastards! That guy's taking some hit!
No! Collectible. Super science. The big book of science fiction. Dynamic novel. Tomorrow. Half past eternity. Vengeance unlimited. Some health.
Angelo's coming through the alleyway. With me.
What? Yeah.
Oh, look at the balls on this kid. You really saved my ass, Tom.
We gotta go, boss. The cops will be here soon.
I need a minute to catch my breath.
Well, let me get you back to the bar.
No, not the bar. We're going to see Carlo. That son of a bitch knew where I was going today, and he calls in sick.
He set you up.
To us, Tom. You could have ended up just as dead.
Yeah, I know, boss.
Carlo's jacked up with some dame in Holbrook. Let's go see what he has to say about all this.
Carlos, you're about to get shit on, my boy. Oh, yikes.
Step on it, Tom. Every minute Carlos still breathing is a minute that's got me pissed.
Sure, boss.
Can't believe these bastards had the brass balls to wreck my car.
Wow, they are everywhere. We're not wanted yet, are we?
Had to be Carlo, didn't it? His pop was tight with Morello right when we started out. Apple don't fall far from the tree, huh? I wept at his funeral. And his sons will be laughing loud. His mom's already a widow, Tom, and now he's gonna make her lonely till the day she dies. For what? Some dough to buy his dope? And my foot through his face.
Yeah, he is.
Whew. Know what? I'm glad. I'm glad this happened. I get to plug another rat,
and
we finally
go
to the mattresses
rage.
With Morello. Today's the day the dam breaks.
Sure feels like it.
You take a guy in. You give him a place in your family. You give him respect. And this is how he repays you?
If he's done this, what else has he squealed on? The farm, the betting house, the ambush at the parking garage. Any of them could have been him.
Carlos, you're about to get your shit beat in. Oh, come on, man.
Boss, why don't you let me go first, huh? Carlo might be waiting for us.
No, Tom. My face is going to be the first and last thing this bastard sees.
What the fuck?
You goddamn dirty grifter.
You better dangle, sweetheart.
It's gonna be a closed casket, Carlo.
Oh! Oh, why my man was hard? Ooh.
You okay, Boss?
Yeah. Just a little one. Let me catch my breath.
Jesus, he's fast for a big guy.
Don't let him get away!
Oh, nice one. What the fuck are you doing?
Help! Help me, someone!
Come back here, Carlo!
I can run a little faster.
They're going to kill me!
Hey, we ain't finished with you!
Tommy, please! I can explain!
Tommy, what the fuck are you doing?
Please! Let me talk to the boss! I can explain everything! Tommy, you gotta know! Morello, he was gonna kill Mom! I had to do it!
So it was him! Ooh!
Do it, Tommy! Please! I can explain!
Fucking dipshit.
Is he still alive?
I'm not sure.
Damn.
Now we're sure.
I definitely shot him in the head. But, okay.
Hey, Sergio, how are you? Keeping out of trouble?
Sure.
Who's this? Wait a minute. Is that Gordy? It is. Hey, Gordy, how you doing, buddy? Hotly recognized you. What'd he do?
You said you were having some trouble down at the docks, right?
Yeah, it's nothing I can't handle.
Yeah, well, I did some asking around. This asshole was planning a strike. Strikes are no good for business. Unless you don't want to call him for it, right?
Right.
So I decided the union needed a little change in leadership. Is that all right with you?
Of course.
Yeah. Now, what about that other thing?
That's why I'm here. Salieri's still alive.
Haha.
God damn it! What happened?
I don't know yet. Crew we sent is dead. Restaurant's all shot to hell.
Stop your crying. Trying to have a conversation here. What about the cockroach Carlo?
Found him with his head smashed in like a fucking watermelon. Never seen anything like it.
So the Salieri must have figured Carlo was the rat. God damn it. Can't even hear myself think.
It's gonna be a war.
I told you to shut the fuck up! We've been at war since we killed Papone. It's just out in the open now.
What do you want me to do?
Make your rounds. Tell little boys to keep their eyes peeled.
They have a lot of balls wearing a white suit. What the shit you're trying to do.
Hey. Just, keep your head down, little brother.
You too, Don Morello.
Bon appetit. All right. We're about to hit 2 hours. Happy birthday.
We're at the start of something. Something big.
You think?
Morello tried to kill the Don. That time.
Hey, you need it up the stairs.
I'll go straight up.
It's war, Thumb. From today, we are at war.
Oh, boy.
Haven't seen any trouble just yet.
Is it true that Don slipped Carlo the bump, not you?
Yeah. It wasn't pretty.
Still blood in his veins, huh?
Lesson, Carlos.
Yeah, that's the truth there, buddy.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
I want guards and lookouts around the clock.
What?
Here, the Where warehouse, are you? And all our businesses.
How about people under our protection?
Forget about that. We stick to our own till this is over.
There's a thingy over I'll there. I want to get it. Side.
Our guy's in place.
Good.
We're finally going after him.
Soon. But first we have to soften him up. Morell's got the cops, the politicians, and even some judges in his pocket. We can't afford to bite them all off, so we need to scare them into abandoning Morell's sinking ship.
We bump off the right idiot, the rest are going to realize sticking with Morello ain't too good for their health.
First in line for the pine box is this asshole, Galati. The Counts are still seeing red over his dead kid, so he's never going to turn on Morello.
Christ. That guy's been giving us fits since 32. Let me take care of him, boss.
Why do you think you're here? Vinny's got it all figured out.
The counselor Vinny is celebrating his birthday with a big shindig on a steamboat. He's pulling out all the stops. Booze, broads, fireworks. He's even giving a speech to the press.
What kind of security?
Just the normal detail, a few guys with Roscoe's. None of the other fellas are gonna do dick to protect that piece of shit.
Okay. I'll talk my way into the party, put two in his head.
Slow down, Junior. Galati's corrupt, but he ain't stupid. His crew be searching everyone who comes on board, so you can't be carried.
So, what? throw him overboard, see if he can swim.
Don't go getting creative on me. You're still going to shoot him, for fuck's sake. When you get on deck, you make for the head. We got a janitor on the take, and he's planted a revolver in the bathroom.
And then you just cool your heels. Mingle. Try not to look like a hatchet man until Galati makes his appearance. You wait for that bastard to start his speech, and only then do you put one between his eyes.
We want it done in public to get people talking.
Sure. But you got a plan for getting back to shore?
Sam and Paul are down the docks working on that. You meet up with them there, and they'll fill you in on the rest of the details.
Okay. Galati's done, boss. You won't have to worry about him after tonight.
I don't doubt it, Tommy.
Buona fortuna, Tom.
Supposed to be in here. There's a fucking thing in there. I can't get it. Oh, it's in here. No. Never mind then.
An excerpt from a presidential address delivered earlier this year. This is part of our series looking back over the president's plans and results since his inauguration. Our responsibility is to all of the people in this country. This is a great national crusade, a crusade to destroy false idols, which is an enemy of the human spirit generated by this depression. Our attack upon these enemies must be without stint.
I saw that dude, but without discrimination. Risk fucking murder.
No sectional, no political distinctions can be permitted. It must, however, be recognized, and I know you will recognize it, that when an enterprise of this character is extended over more than 3,100 counties throughout the nation,
oh, Sammy boy.
Attention, folks, attention. We'll get you all aboard, but we will need to see chicken.
The finest family in the city.
No doubt.
Roberto Gelati welcomes you to a delightful birthday soiree aboard the Lost Heaven Queen. Boarding 3 p.m., sailing 4 p.m., drinks and food 4 p.m. to 7 p.m., speech and fireworks 7 p.m., entertainment till late. Captain William R. Porter and the crew of the Lost Heaven Queen will be taking us out of the West River, then past Central Island and the lofty heights of Beach Hill. The scenic views of the St. Paul coast will then be yours to take in as we approach the fireworks barges set up in preparation for our grand event.
Who's done more?
An all-day
Terrence! You got an invite too? Oh, did you hear there's gonna be fireworks?
You don't look like a guy with an invite.
I got friends. Just not these kind of friends.
Well, I'll tell you what I got. Sailor back there who works on the steamer. His head hit something heavy. But his dandy white suit's fine.
Thanks. I'll go find him.
We found. Oh, what was it? Marcio Morello. The man in the white suit, the criminal that criminals fear. Morello is a friend to establishment in high society, all the while corrupting them from the inside. He murders, he exploits, and he profits, impulsively moving from one legal enterprise to the next. Ever since the death of notorious crime lord Don Pepone, Morello has been the dominant force felt in Lost Heaven. Few dare to stand against him. Those who do rarely live long. Ripmeister over here, oh my goodness. Absolutely killing it.
Know you'd get a real job someday.
Shut up.
So remember, play it cool. When you've gone some ways over the water, find the gun. The janitor stashed it in the bathroom.
Sure.
Then get up on the roof. Wait for Galati's speech and pop him when he's done.
How do I get away?
Polly's borrowed a speedboat. After the speech, there's fireworks. We'll come soon as we've seen.
A speedboat? Define speedboat for the 1930s.
Don't worry. It'll go smooth like eggs and coffee.
Looking good, Tom.
Huh?
The outfit don't get messed up. Keep it. Suits ya.
Fuck off.
You the new guy? Christ, you took your time.
You think he's gonna pull this off?
He sure as shit gonna kill Galati. Getting off that boat? Well, he's gonna need a guardian angel.
He don't need no fucking angel. He's got us looking out for him.
Done?
Yeah. Was gonna go clean the bathrooms. Heard some guests complaining.
You're volunteering to clean toilets? Whatever. You got a rag there. Check every deck.
Roberto Gelati welcomes you to a I already read this.
Don't I know you from someplace?
Nah, don't think so.
I swear I know you. Were you with the Union, maybe?
Sorry, buddy, I'm from out of town.
Listen, shitmate, go someplace else.
All right. Good.
I think I got him in trouble. What? You think you're something you're not?
Wow. Some bitches.
Seen the janitor any place?
Nah, but if I
I had to put money on it, drunk in the engine room.
Yeah, perfect. All right. Let's try and find this book.
He's a man with connections. Where else do you think the boots go?
The science classic of the year, Tumatok of the Towers of Fire, Lost Legion, a full-length novel.
Say my name again, and you'll be found floating outside. Get that?
Yeah, I get that.
What are you gonna do about it?
Well, I'm gonna give you a beat for starters. Found ya!
Jeez,
that hurts.
Yeah.
Should be here!
Come on. Where the fuck are you?
Reading the detective comics up here. Oh my goodness. You can die any day. A max Latin novelette. More deadly than the male. What the fuck is she doing? Okay, there's definitely gonna be a gunfight up here.
Hey, John. Hope you're enjoying yourself.
As long as the bar stays open, counselor.
Good man. Have another for me, huh? Good to see you. Thanks for coming.
Hey, thank you, everyone. Thank you. Hey, welcome to my little party, right?
Little party.
So, as you all know, it has been a tough time. 3 years ago, my dear son, Billy, left us. An innocent pawn in a deadly gang war. A victim of the deceased, that is, organized crime. Since that day, I have lived
like a
only
Donald
to
Trump
eradicate
to
this decease. Today is a day for celebration for my 50th birthday. And for a brighter future for Lost Heaven. The criminals will be driven out of town. They'll drown like rats in the water. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. And now for the fireworks, huh?
Holy shit.
You're in my sight.
Okay, okay. What? Yeah. Shit. I'm Sergio.
Stay on it! What do you think I'm trying to do?
I think so.
Faster!
No! No!
Could be worse, huh? We could be peeling you off the front of the train.
He just got a good break is all.
Sergio Morella's always been lucky. He was born with more brains than his brother, that's for sure.
We'll get him, boss.
No, you two are off this job. You're broken mirrors on this one. We'll let the guy who killed Galati take a crack. Tommy here's got all the politicians scared. Maybe he can put Sergio in the ground.
What do I need to know about this guy?
Besides, he's got a lucky rabbit's foot up his ass.
Sergio is Morello's top earner. He controls the unions, which means he controls the docks and attacks everything that's imported into the city. We kill him, and a big part of Morello's income will be wiped out.
Any ideas on how to get to him? I don't want to end up in a tree like these two.
You're going to scatter his ashes. It's a custom job. Attach it to the starter under his car. He'll be a human torch as soon as he turns the key.
It's safe to carry.
Hey, just don't drop it. Shake it. Smoke near it. Yeah, it's safe. Boom!
Get it done, Tommy. For all our guys, Morello's killed. And for all the money he's taken out of our pockets.
I'll take care of it, boss.
Alrighty. Oh, we can finally go in here. I'm gonna read this thing and I'm gonna take a piss break. Hey! Okay, this is a dope ass picture. Nice. This is the dude who I think died. Papone's legacy looms large over Lost Heaven. Under his rule, the Italian gangs took root and flourished. His wiles first corrupted the police and politicians. His intuition and mentorship saw that his capos, Ennio Salieri and Marco Morello, would one day rule in his place. In 1921, Don Felice Papone died in a deal gone wrong. But in truth, the city will never have the luxury of forgetting him. So Papone was like the leader of it all, but then mentored Ennio Salieri and Morello, but now Sorello and Salieri are kind of at their throats, and now we're in a war. You're telling me we're just gonna pull up to this dude's house?
There's no way they'd come here.
I used to run with his crew. If Morello wakes up one morning and wants to come heavy, he'll come heavy.
Nah, now he won't.
I want that really long car.
From the news desk of WLH 570, a special report on crime in our city. It had been hoped by lawmakers and the general public alike that the end of Prohibition would cut off the mob's air supply. But 2 years since the repeal of the 18th Amendment, it seems to have merely added fuel to the conflagration of crime that engulfs the country. It would appear that removing the conditions that created a new type of virulent gangsterism is not going to remove the problem. The criminal empires that amassed such wealth and power in the last decade and a half are simply too powerful, too deep-rooted to simply be swept away. The more established of these organizations are consolidating their power. The competition between them continues to bring violence and bloodshed into the public square. We saw this in Empire Bay with the Vinci Moretti War that ended in the car bomb killing of mob boss Tommaso Moretti. Gangs such as the Vinci family are now, in many cases, highly sophisticated, well-organized international operations. They owe their success to their brutality and to the many lawmen and legislators in their pockets. Yes, don't allow yourself to be mistaken. The mob may be the instigator, the driving partner, but the corrupt politician or the dirty cop is the facilitator, and both roles must be played for organized crime to flourish. I've heard it mentioned in certain situations that the upward trajectory of the economy would quell the mob's opportunities to exploit police and lawmakers. That, sadly, doesn't appear to be the case. Those engaged in corruption are not doing so to put food on the table. City officials and public servants earn more than most, and did so even at the height of the Depression. So that, frankly, does not wash. Plenty of people far worse off live without sin. As we have seen in Lost Heaven, standing up to the mob can be a dangerous game. Suspected mob hits carried out against officials in a number of American cities attest to that. What are our state and federal governments doing to ease public concerns? What can we expect from J. Edgar Hoover and his BOI, now renamed the Federal Bureau of Investigations? Are we...
Yeah, that's gotta be Sergio's car. How am I gonna get through to it?
You lost?
No, I'm just taking a walk. Go around. Never mind. Okay, buddy, you don't even fall over.
Who do you think you are?
Bob, is it who?
Ooh, a Doom Terror Tale. But what in the hell?
That is not how you use a guillotine.
Slaves for the wine goddess. Eerie mystery terror. Not what? The monster's hungry.
Alright. I'm gonna go...
This break time, you guys can look at this good old stuff. I'll be back.
We back.
Gotta get this checked out.
Yeah, I'll be home before supper. Hey, you wanna go dancing this weekend? Maybe drop the kid off at your pop's place. Yeah, I'm still here. Oh, Christ.
Hey! Stop!
Oh, shit.
No. It all went bad.
Hey, pull it together, Tom. Whatever happened, happened. There's nothing you can do about it now. Sergio's luck is running out.
What are you talking about?
Sam and Paulie have found him. He's in Georgie's restaurant across town. You need to get over there fast.
Okay.
So now we just fucking did this for nothing. We just killed an innocent old fucking lady. You gotta be shitting me.
Now, for a news report. And the biggest story of the day is that the chief of police admits his men have yet to apprehend any suspects in the brazen public assassination.
What the fuck, bro? Something's wrong with Sam or Polly. It's one or the other. There's something fishy, something corrupt about those two. I thought when Salieri, his restaurant fucking got shot up, I thought it was either Sam or Polly. But Carlos did fess up. He was like, yeah, it was me. I'm sorry. But I don't know. After seeing Mafia 3, I just feel like it's gonna be like that. I haven't played all of Mafia 3. I might do a Mafia thing.
Tara, you okay?
Yeah, it's a car bomb. Things went south.
We could draw about it later. Right now, we gotta get that bastard. Let's go.
He is very lucky. He dodged that bullet by a fucking, inch.
What the hell? We got a message from Mr. Salieri.
No!
Kill these clowns!
Let me get my fucking collectible, goddammit.
He went out the back!
A horse of another killer. Sergio.
Calm down, Tom.
Oh, I need another gun.
Get away from
here.
Get me out of here.
Get back to the car. We gotta catch up before that idiot gets himself killed.
Oh, fuck yeah. Did they not have these bikes in Mafia 1, like the original? I'm pretty sure they didn't. This is the original. I thought they were never gonna use them, but they actually are. I can't actually do anything. Damn, hey, Paulie.
So get it! Got it, Sam!
Because there's not a lot I can do here. Other than keep up with them until they stop. What the fuck's going on? They had semi trucks? Falling ass. Oh, fuck it. I gotta hit it. No! No. Can't hit me. Okay. I can't like shoot back. Oh fuck. God. Are we all the way at the beginning? Are we fucking serious? That was so unfucking lucky. There's literally nothing I can do. I have to stay far enough away. I can hit that jump next time. I'm so far out of the way.
Oh my. Oh! Oh my lord. Oh! I gotta get back. There's nothing I can do in this situation. Get out of my way, old man.
Move out the way!
It's literally the worst part. I can't shoot. I can't. Okay. Let's watch for that fucking taxi. Get back. Don't. You can't shoot from here. No.
Turn and try that
game. Get away. Holy, where are you? Help.
Doing. Kill that motherfucker!
Get every gun we got down here now!
He's coming this way! This ain't good! Rip! We lost him!
Okay, fuckhead.
Burn him out! Molotov going up!
Oh, fuck! Jeff, fuck!
Sweet dream!
No!
Get him from the side! Got a shot! Get in the shot! Now, together! Okay. Fuck off. God damn. What do you want me to do? Fucking hell. Fucker. What the fuck? I'm out of ammo, bro. What do you want me to do? Jesus Christ. What?
No, I don't think so.
Try to shake him! Jeez! I see him! Lining up for shot! Over here!
Oh. Oh, motherfucker. Stay. Huh? Huh?
They're coming for you.
No. Son of a bitch. Damn. Okay.
Burn him! Fireball! He's on my ass!
Whew. Yummy pills. Ah, fuck. Okay. You motherfucker. Ha ha! Well, motherfucker! Go over!
fuck? What happened? Some kind of fucking train?
Found him!
Yeah! Ever to throw that. There's a Molotov out, and then 10 seconds later, just chucks it all the way to the moon, and it falls right on me. Oh my god.
Over here! Got any last words?
Motherfucker! Stop it. Get the cover. What are you doing?
Asshole, you think you're the guy who's gonna kill me?
What?
What did I tell you? No one can touch me.
You ain't that lucky, bastard.
Wait. No!
Damn. Creme de la creme. Whoa. Hey. Pause. There's no audio. Stop. What the fuck? Okay, Alt F4 it is. We'll try that again. We still got time. Since my watermark hasn't shown up yet. Hope you guys are enjoying the stream so far. Let's see if we can get some audio on that. We'll just... Okay. Never mind. Okay. It might be a glitch with the game, but... It's kind of annoying. It seems like a big cutscene, so I kind of want to hear it. Be hitting 3 hours soon.
After we killed Sergio, it was chaos for weeks. Our guys against their guys, and Morello gone to ground. But a boss can't stay hidden forever. For a Don to be feared, he's gotta be seen. Finally, word came through that he was gonna break cover.
Morello wants to thumb his nose at us. Taking a show like there's not a war on, we'll meet him in the streets.
We do him like this. We wait outside the theater till the end of the show. All those rich assholes will start coming out. That's when we hit Morello and his gorillas in a crowd before they see us coming.
The theater's going to be packed, and not just with saps. There's a good chance the mayor, maybe even the chief, might be there too.
That's the goddamn point, Tom. We kill Morello in public, in front of the city's creme de la creme. Then they'll all know who's in charge. And it doesn't matter if you have a badge or a gavel or a fat wad of cash in your pocket. If you cross Salieri and his boys, you're dead.
Okay, boss. We'll get it done.
Take the machine guns. Make sure you don't draw attention to yourselves hanging around outside the theater. You keep the choppers hidden until you spot Morello.
And then you light them up. I want it to look like that white suit is covered in roses. You got it?
Sure, boss.
Alrighty.
This is it. We're finally doing this. Keep your head. We gotta get to the theater before the show's over. Tom, you're driving.
As always.
We got the word, boys. Morello dies tonight.
Tonight?
Shit. Good luck, guys.
Put your foot down, Tom. Can't believe after all these years, we're finally going after Morello. Not his crew, not his family. Finally putting him in the ground.
We're putting a lot of history to rest.
What happens when he's gone?
This is perfect.
We'll be kings.
Nah, I mean, what happens with the Don? You think he'll be all tore up?
I think he'll start wearing a nice white suit. Boy's doing all right.
Yeah, just sweating bullets.
You look how I feel.
Nearly there. Let's keep it together. When we see him, go for Morello. No one else.
Once he's down, his guys will panic.
We're actually doing this. He's been up against the boss for what, 10 years?
More. You'd think that white suit would make him an easier target.
This game is fucking awesome. I love it. What the fuck? I press the fucking ram button, and he's like, yeah, let me just take a hard right into the fucking...
Come on, Tom! Get back on that fat fuck's ass!
I can't do anything now.
Morello must have been plenty nervous. Fuck his guys are out of force. Take him out if you can, but Morello's the prize tonight.
Oh, fuck, they turned! Fuck me!
You're still an ice...
Oh my god, I'm just gonna fucking low lesser point. God damn. Alrighty.
Chase
that
him
was
down,
fucking
Tom.
Horrid.
The
dot'll
hang us out to dry.
When I get close, shoot for the cars protecting it. Let's get him out of the picture.
Man, motherfucker!
Got cops on us.
No
Bunch
shit, dip shit.
Around the theater.
Last time they get paid off by Morello. Tomorrow, they're ours.
I gotta fucking lose him. Oh god.
Nervous. His guys are out of force. Take him out of
fucking
camp.
Turn.
Morello's the prize tonight. Come on, fellas. We're taking this city over.
One more car.
If we lose him, we'll go to ground for months. More, maybe.
Don't let him give us a slip. He could be headed anywhere.
If we don't
just
catch him
hey,
slugging, he might even move out of state for a while. We need to whack him tonight. That's right, Tom! Off in the back streets.
I know this city better than anyone. Don't worry.
Okay, Tom.
This is gonna be a squeeze.
Morello's gotten himself a good driver, but he doesn't match you, Tom.
Thank you, Paulie. I love you. Alrighty. Man, this fucking car's fast as a bitch. Fuck off! God damn!
Where's he going? He can't be skipping town with us going bumper to bumper with him.
But wherever he's going there in a hurry.
It's the airstrip. He's gonna go through the back. He's got a plane? Of course he's got a goddamn plane!
What the fuck was that?
There'll be more guys waiting. Good! We need to clean house! He's gotta die! This guy's gotta die!
Okay, but let's keep us three off your list.
They only just fixed up the airport since the last time.
Oh, yeah.
He's got muscle waiting!
I see him!
Oh, shit! Yeah. God damn it!
Everyone okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. Just a bit of glass in my hair.
Not that it seemed calm, can't fix.
Then we go after him on foot, come on!
Damn, what a toss!
They got a new guy coming! Some new guns!
Whoa.
Get up their side!
Ah, fuck. God damn it. I don't want to play the rest of it with that fucking watermark there. Ooh. Actually, you guys can't see it since I'm not doing display capture. I'm only doing game capture. I can deal with that. Give me one second, y'all. All right, this can work. I can deal with it for a little bit if this is the end of the game. After this mission.
Son of a bitch!
Come on!
They called in the rest of their crew!
Luciano Meccano. One brother a leader, another a brute, a third a runt, a forgotten man forever in the shadow of his siblings. Sal Meccano has the brains. Lou has the brawn, and Lucio, the ability to follow, to obey, and to never ask questions. Today, Meccano family voraciously eats into territory left in the wake of the deceased mobster, Giuseppe Carrillo. The help of his brothers will see Lucio go far, but perhaps not far enough.
Man shot his own cover.
Stay down. I got a new guy. Give us back up.
Oh,
something through the back here.
Detective. Oh, fuck. Okay. Tin Pan Alibi.
Come on, Tom. Murillo's gotta be close.
What the fuck do you guys think that is? It's a fucking plane. Why is there a car? We're gonna chase him.
Into that car! Tommy's up front. You're the best shot out of all of us.
Oh.
Get in the damn car!
I am in the damn car.
Get us into the air! We don't have the speed!
It's gonna take off! Shoot out the engines! Are we even making a dent? It's no good! This isn't gonna work!
It has to work!
He's in a fucking plane!
Cannon, let me shoot! He's not out of here yet! I'm taking the wheel.
Why?
Because I'm the guy that drives. And now we got a plane to catch.
What the fuck did we do? I can crawl over him?
We follow it. We see where it lands. We rush in, all guns blazing, and we finish him off. No way that bird's staying in the sky.
That thing's not going to land. It's going to crash.
We won't tell the Don about that one.
So what was I saying?
Oh, right. That thing's not going to land. It's going to crash. It look, aeronautic to you?
But thank Christ we got you in the car, Professor.
Morello's not gonna walk away from a plane crash.
That's a maybe, but he ain't dead till we seen him dead. Out of all of us, you two should know that by now.
That is true. Ah, fuck.
Police are on to us.
Well, fuck me then. What? God damn it. This is a fucking shit show now. I don't know what y'all expected to happen. What the? Fuck out of here. We've lost all sight of plane. So easily.
He's out of sight. I know there's a lot of ground to go.
We don't have time to relax. We gotta be sure he's dead before the cops show. No one's gonna survive that.
Hell of a lot of smoke. I can't believe we did this.
And no, don't seem real.
Stay alert with your guns close. We've come too far to get lazy at the end.
We don't have long. Every cop in the city is gonna be on his way.
We get out, we...
You already let happen.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, fuck.
Bastard's daddy doesn't even know it yet. He knows it now.
Yeah, pal. That'll do it.
Come on. Let's make tracks.
See you on the other side, Marku.
Whatever happens real quick, I'm gonna end it. Intermezzo. Oh.
You fucking phantom. I've been chasing you for 3 goddamn years. You'll do life for this, Tom. Maybe you in the chair.
You don't want the guy who was punching tickets. You want the guy who was handing them out.
So that's what this has been all about, huh? You offering up Salieri?
The Don's books. The ones Frank stole. I have them. They're enough to put Salieri away forever, and they're yours. Assuming we have a deal. My family for the Don.
Do you recognize anyone? Look again. Old man, that's Don Popone. 2 younger lads of Morello and Salieri.
Yeah. Okay, I see it. That must be what? 1920?
April. Morello's wedding. Salieri was the best man.
Jesus. They're just kids.
Not already soldiers in Popone's map. So what happened? How did they go from being best mates to Morello on a slab?
I don't know. I didn't even know they were friends.
But you don't know could fill up the fucking Chrysler building. In 22. Popone drowns up at the lake. Right? In order to keep things running smoothly, Salieri and Morello created divvy up the city.
Yeah, okay. I heard the story, so what?
Right, a friendship should have made the deal work, but didn't make a lick of difference.
That's what confuses me.
After Morello, Salieri was beaming, thinking we ran the whole damn town. Me, I was just happy the war was over. But then I got to thinking about something. What good was all of Morello's money if it couldn't protect him from a regular Joe like me? Cabbie, for Christ's sake. It only got him one thing. A great big bullseye in his fucking forehead. And that thought, it just kept turning round and round in my head until one day, I'm looking in a mirror. I start seeing a bullseye too. Right here.
Dry your tears of the water hundreds, do you?
I wasn't about to give up the good life, I know that. I just told myself that I was smarter than Morello. That I wouldn't turn around one day and find Polly or Sam pointing a gun at my head. The thing is, you don't see it. When you're out on a street, scrapping, fighting for your life, then the guy next to you isn't just your partner, he's your brother. You'd stick a knife in someone for your brother, right? But at night, you lie awake, wondering what he and Adam were whispering about behind the bar. Wondering if your best friend is hungry enough to betray you.
Shit. All right. Well. Oh, fuck.
Any trouble?
No, boss. No trouble at all.
Got something else for me?
Thank you.
Paulie's feels a little light.
There's a little extra in mine to cover the difference.
You ever go swimming, Tom?
Been to the shore a few times, sure.
I knew a couple of guys once. Took some dames out to the lake. Had a few beers, a few laughs. Then one of them decides to go in the water. Gets to the center of the lake and realizes he's running out of steam. Can't make it back in. He starts shouting for help. Now the other guy, he's a strong swimmer. He goes out in the lake to drag his buddy back to shore. Problem is, the first guy, the one too stupid to know when the water's too deep for him, he panics. Grabs his friend by the neck and they both go under and don't come up again. Paulie's your friend. And I know you're loyal to him. And I respect that. But don't you ever pay his tab again.
Okay, boss.
Good. Now, we gotta talk about this Turnbull.
The guy running for governor?
The same. He's been flapping his gums a lot about cracking down on our businesses.
That's rich. He spent more on whores than Paulie and Sam combined. You want me to pay him a visit? Maybe put him on a take?
No. You can't trust the hypocrite, Tom. We need to end his campaign aspirations, and in a way that keeps anyone from stepping up to the same platform.
Vinny, have a plan then?
Of course. Turnbull's holding a rally near Central Island. The spot he picked is hard to reach and out in the open. Should have a beautiful view of the rally from the tower of the old prison. From there, you'll give Turnbull the third eye.
Okay. I'll go see Vinny about the gun.
But don't forget, you only got one shot. You miss, and his crew will usher him out of there quick.
I'm the best shooter you got. Otherwise, you'd be talking to someone else.
Then get it done.
All right. Well, I'm gonna call this stream. I might start another one later. I'm not sure yet. I might take the rest of the night and not. So, that being said, I'll see you guys in the next part.